guys, hi Wicked10 here. So today I am going to be showing you my car brochure collection. So I've been collecting brochures for quite a long time now, probably since like March at least, or maybe even before. Well, it's not a long time, but I guess it is in a way. Basically, I have lots and lots of brochures, far too many as a matter of fact. And I know I haven't done a video for a while, so I just sort of wanted to get back into it and, you know, start doing more videos more often. So we're going to start off with this one. Now this is on the Suzuki S-Cross, which is like basically a 4x4 by Suzuki. It's very nice, it's full of nice pictures. It tells you like everything about the model itself, as a brochure should. It's got really nice things to look at. And yeah, that's probably my favourite image. And if you haven't noticed, I now have a spinny chair. So I'm very happy because I can now spin around and I can go up and I can go down. So I'm very happy about that. So I'm going to get the next brochure now. So this one is on the Suzuki Ignis, which is a very sort of cute looking, it's basically a crossover between a city car and a 4x4. Very nice. And the most important part of this is the fact that it opens up like that. So it's like really awesome. And I'm very glad that I have it. And by the way, these brochures don't cost anything. You just basically go on the dealer's website, order a brochure, give them your address, and they will just give you one for free. So if you're a car fan like myself, as you probably have noticed by now, then you can just order them online. I've got this one. It's hardly a brochure, but it's basically just a bit of, well, it's like an information thing about this new Suzuki Swift, which has only been out like 2 or 3 weeks. And I got it just before it was released. And it says arrives June 2017. So I was very happy to get that. Next I have the Suzuki Solario brochure. Now, we actually have one of these cars, so I thought it'd be good to get one. We only got our car in like February. But yeah, they're great little cars, really economical. And yeah, lots of nice pictures. And when we got it, it was $6,999, but now it's like $7,499. So it's gone up a fair amount. But that's probably something to do with the EU. Next I have the Dacia Sandero, cheapest car in the UK at only $5,999. I'm sorry if you can hear them noisy people outside. I don't know what they're doing. They're just being very loud. This car is quite nice. I mean, not my favourite, but you know, it's another brochure to add to the collection. I have a Hyundai. I think this is the i10. May I just say that it is very hot. It's at least 28 degrees. Well, when I checked in the car it was. It is so hot. It says tomorrow's gonna be cooler, so hopefully it will be. Yep, I was right, it's on the Hyundai i10. I've got a paper cut there. Yeah, it's quite a little car, but very economical and practical, which is what you really want these days for a car. Especially if you like doing school trips and lots of shopping around cities. We have the Peugeot 108. This is my least favourite brochure. I just don't feel like it's very well put together, and it's a bit like boring, to be honest. It's not my favourite one. But, you know, it's okay for Peugeot lovers, I guess. We have the Dacia Duster, which is the cheapest 4x4 going at only around probably 11.5 grand. So it's pretty cheap for a 4x4. And yes, next I have the Kia Picanto. This is the all new one. It's pretty snazzy, I think. And yeah, I've actually got the one that came out before this too, which you'll see in a bit. But yes, very nice car. I have the Toyota Yaris, which is again another city car, but interesting to read about all the features and everything. And you even get a little letter. So yeah, I feel special because I'm getting letters now. We have the Suzuki Vitara. Now, there was a Suzuki, I think it was called Grand Vitara, that was like released in the 1990s, but now there's a new version, like pretty much came out in probably 2013, 2014, and it looks really good in that colour, aqua blue I call it. And yes, if you want the standard model, you have to have it in white, unless of course you pay 400 quid extra for the paint. Probably my biggest brochure, the BMW 1 Series. So that's basically on BMWs. It's actually the cheapest one. I think it's around 20 to 22,000. So still quite a lot, but you know, you're looking into luxury cars here. So, you know, luxury cars are going to be expensive. Like, that's something you have to know and understand about. Like, BMWs and Mercedes and Bentleys. We have this one. This is probably one of my oldest brochures, Toyota Aygo. I mean, it's an okay car, but not my favourite. However, I think that looks pretty good. I think, when did I get this one? 8th of March 2017. So yeah, that was like one of my early ones that I got. Probably been collecting them for 3-4 months now. Promise guys, this is nearly over. However, we have another luxury car. This is the Volvo XC90. Now this brochure's a bit different because it's like, instead of it being like, how do you explain it? This one's like just paper, like with things printed out on it. I mean, that is too, but it's got a different sort of texture. Like this is just rough paper, whereas the others are like plasticky. Very in depth, very detailed. Even comes with a little price and specification leaflet thing. But it's not really a leaflet, but whatever it is, I don't even know. Either way, I just thought I'd mention, I have a fidget spinner. Wait, why is it not spinning? Eh? Not spinning anymore. It does it a bit, but I don't know what's happened here. I've only got about 4 more, including this one. This one is the Suzuki Jimny. I think this car's very cool. Like, it's a 4x4, but even though it's small, it's pretty, like, it's pretty strong for a car. Like, it can tow things, and it's quite a strong little car really, because it can get up places where other cars can't go. This is the one I've been waiting for a long time, the all new Suzuki Swift, which has only been out for like a week or two. Very snazzy, very awesome looking. See, it's got one of these pages that sort of flips. And I think that one looks very good in white. Tells you like the standard model and the high spec. And it's got technical specifications here, like if you want to know the turning circle or the wheel size or the max speed, 0 to 60 even. Even though most modern cars these days have top speeds of 96, when will you ever need to go 96 miles an hour in the UK? You won't, will you? Because, like, the maximum speed limit in the UK is like 70 on the motorway. Yet people do exceed that. They're just very naughty people. They should be ashamed of themselves. Last two brochures now. This is the Kia Picanto that came out just before the other one I showed you before. Basically the same inside, apart from the different, like, features, because if a new model comes, it'll have better features than the older model. Now this one was going to be my dream car. Well, it was for a while, but I don't know anymore. This is the Toyota GT86. Very nice looking. Look at that. So nice. I'm sorry if it's gone a bit dark. It's just that there's lots of cloud. I think it might thunder. And it's even got a picture of an old car in there next to the new one. I don't know why they added that. But yes, if you want to see what all these brochures look like in my hands, then I will show you now. I could barely fit them all in, but this is pretty much the majority. Just drop one, oh well. But yeah, I've got far too many. I really need to stop collecting them now. While I'm at it, I thought I might as well show you the car we used to have. Very nice car, Citroen 2CV. And I've been trying to trace this car and I finally found it. So yeah, and it's been restored, which is a nice thing. So I'm happy. And one day, I may even buy it back. Who knows? I may have broken my fidget spinner. If I have, I'll be very upset. It spins a bit, but it usually spins for about 3 minutes. But yes, I will sort that out and probably have it fixed for my next video, which will probably be a Q&A, because I wanted to do a Q&A video, because I haven't done one in a while. So if you guys have any questions to ask, then feel free to put them in the comments or on Twitter. If you're friends with me on Facebook, then just Facebook message me. I think it's pretty much broken. Damn it. I'm gonna have to get a new one, aren't I? So much for that, eh? Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe. Please give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And I will see you guys all next time, which, as I said, will probably be a Q&A. So yeah, ask me questions if you feel like it. If you don't, I haven't got a problem with that. But yes, thank you for watching this video. And I will see you guys all next time. Bye.